You're listening to the Wandering But Not Lost podcast, where real estate and reality meet. Join us and subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Google Play, and now on YouTube.
So let's dive into this just quick little overview, because in our Facebook next week, I will go into demonstrating it a little bit more because it'll be, you know, a video on Facebook. But I do want to talk a little bit about what's in this workbook. Matt, can we bring it up?
We certainly can.
So if you're watching on the video on YouTube, or if you're listening, you can go to YouTube. But if it's past Monday, whatever day, Monday is 7th, I think, just go to our Facebook group and you'll be able to get me kind of walking through this document. So on the podcast, I'm just going to describe what we have and what it's meant to be. And there, honestly, I don't know how many pages are in here, but
I think it's about 26 pages. It's a long document.
Whatever, we happen to like the number 26.
Yeah, we do. It's very interesting, isn't it?
The size of our workbook for the Plan, Pivot, Prosper. But what we did is I just compiled, and Matt helped me create 4 years ago, various little things. And you just might find one or two things in here that are useful for you. So let me just describe it as, for those of you that are watching, there's a cover, obviously. And where is that cover, by the way? I recognize that height.
This actually, yeah, and for the user that aren't actually looking at the screen, we use photography from Travels, Wandering, pictures from Wandering But Not Lost. And this particular year, we're just showing different paths in National Park. So the cover of this is actually Mount Rainier in Washington State.
Oh, it looked familiar. So I haven't been there. So that's on one of your recent trips. Okay. Well, I love it. I like the path. Beautiful. That's why there's a path, and there's a path. Describing it with some wonderful, you know, evergreen trees in the front. There you go. Do you have the visual, podcast listeners?
Okay. Yeah, exactly. Now, yeah.
In the booklet, there's a little overview about what it is, what's included in it, a little agenda. All right. And so it starts with a year in review. Now, why this is not as deep as the business planning guide. This is more meant to just be high level. And honestly, we developed this so that anybody, not even in real estate, could use this. So it's just your numbers, you know, what was your revenue? What was your expenses? What was your pre-tax net? Where'd your business come from? And what are the takeaways? So this is meant to be sort of you did a deep dive in October, if you're with us for business planning, but this is just how did I do? Did I make, you know, where did my business come from? And what did I learn last year? Okay, that's all there is to that. Continuing on, there's just nothing more than a blank page for brainstorming. I don't know about you, Matt, but I like to just sometimes jot down things or sure. Do a mind map, a true mind map where you draw. You know, I'm going through old stuff and everything, and I've come across, oh my God, for my original coaching company idea, I found the mind map of that, you know?
That's so cool.
You know, so you just use circles, whatever works for you. So this is just a what's on your mind, do a brain dump. Okay, brainstorming, mind mapping. Then you've done your one-year goals if you've been tracking along with us. And so there's a longer-term goal in here. And by the way, this is an editable PDF that you can print it out and write it in if you want to, but you can also, Matt, painstakingly put the editable boxes in this PDF for you. I don't know how long it took them, but I think it's 100 and something boxes.
There are 180 text boxes in here. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Matt. That's a lot of work to make it editable for you.
Oh, just funny, on that note, to digress for a minute, Jan goes, why don't we just make one of these that's just not, it's just more generic and not to the year? And I said, no, we don't want to do that, because if we have people that have been doing this for 5 years, we want their things to be unique. So every year they can go back and they have their old plan and it's got the date on it. Plus, it's got actual beautiful images from all the different years.
Well, then it was worth it. Okay.
Yeah, absolutely.
Actually, I have the first edition with the, exactly. So there's 2, 5, 10 years. And I find that useful, because that's kind of where I am in my life. It's like, where do I see myself in 5 years? And this is just meant for you to either jot some bullets down or draw the picture of, you know, what does that look like for you? And there's just power in getting it out and putting it into a document. And then from the long-term goals, we move on to, okay, this is, I'm going to talk more about this in a coming podcast, and it's a call about intentions and focus. And I pulled on something that I had seen years ago. I like feng shui, you know, the whole study of feng shui as it relates to real estate, but also feng shui in your house and how you subconsciously, you know, the Chinese art of feng shui, where you place things. And but when you set intention to how you do certain things, whether we're talking about doing it in your home or your desktop, or you set stuff up, it's a reflection of where you are. Now, what this does is take those principles and then it ties it into 9 areas of your life. So wealth, prosperity, you know, your reputation, it's fame, and it's called fame in the Chinese feng shui, but it can also be legacy. So all the way through relationships, family, health, creativity. And the idea here is to just focus on, it can be whatever you want this to be, but I'll cover more in detail. It can be a focus word, one thing, keep it simple, that you want to focus on in creativity or travel or career or knowledge, like self-knowledge. And, or it could be a list of one or two things that you want to do, or it could just be a word that is the focus for the year. But I also like the idea of, again, we'll do this in a future podcast, picking a focus word and a mantra for the year. But that's inside of this as well. And we're going to pull this out and do a separate episode on it. Okay. Now the 333, we like the numbers threes when we created this. And these are just nine boxes for personal, business, and fun or travel that are just meant in 2021. What are three things personally for you, three big things for you business-wise, and three things that you want to make accomplish in the not business and personal area, right? So that could be hopefully traveling again, but it could just be a hobby or something that you're going to go do for yourself. And if we are quarantined for a little bit, not necessarily quarantined, but if we are staying at home more, then maybe it's time to just flip the switch a little bit about what could you be working on that you could do in your home. Maybe there's some creative thing or something that you've been meaning to want to work on or study. This is what this document's for, right? And then there's a piece in here for, this is just a take on the getting things done, that's called the details. And this is meant, like, if you had a project to say you were going to reorganize your garage, okay, or do something in your home, you know, perhaps, or whatever the heck it is. So what's the goal or project? What's the deadline, budget, resources? What's your plan of action so you could kind of organize the details of what you're going to do? So it could be something like that, a home project, or it could be a business system or anything that you're going to do. So a real simple way. And then there's a monthly roadmap. Now, I actually love this. The first year that we designed this, it's got the months of the year there. And then again, it's 333 monthly roadmap. So is there something you're going to do in January to support you personally, that's something you want to make happen, something for your business, and then something to get you up and get out, or get up and stay in, but do something.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. What this helped me do is plan my year for when am I going to take a trip somewhere? When am I going to go visit family? Whether, you know, you could use for anything. It's just meant to be, look at it. It's a smaller version of taking the annual calendar and plotting things. So this is not like details of things you're doing in your business necessarily, but it may be something you're starting, or a project, or something that you're going to, like in business, it could simply be a focus area that you're going to do for the first quarter and then the next quarter. So it's just meant to help you with doing some planning. This is just all about overall planning in all of your life, all parts of your life, right?
Well, this is to that point, it's a good exercise to really tell you how important business planning can be. So let's say you're in your get up and get out section. You do have a big trip you have planned, let's say in the third quarter. Well, you may need to make some money in quarter one and two to be able to afford that trip in the third quarter. You know what I mean? So it can motivate you to get that done, or your goal hit in your business side of the 333 monthly roadmap. So yeah,
I like it. You could use,
because you're seeing your whole year. You know, I remember the first year we did this, Jen and Brian, Jen and I both love national parks, and we were talking about where we wanted to go and blah blah blah. I think you had three national parks planned.
That's exactly the point. Thank you. I started to say that, and you helped me come back to it. But I like what you just said. This could be like, let's say in April I was going to take a trip, and so in April I have Sequoia or something, and. And then, so to that point, what are business? Maybe I need to put a dollar goal in there to hit. This is my, I want to visualize seeing 10 grand or 8 grand or 5 grand or whatever. Or it could be a project that you have to finish. So the whole point of this is that we have a tendency to, especially with everything that we're doing and I'm doing and we're coaching people, there's so many things that I start talking to somebody about. So I was just thinking of someone that started coaching, and it's like, here's a list of all these things that we're going to work on this year. So you could use this roadmap to say, in the first quarter, I'm going to focus on everything I need to do for my database, because I have like five things I need to do. So that's the focus in January and February. And then I'm going to go move on to fine tuning my listing process. So that's another example of something you could do, so you could see that you're going to get to it. And on the personal side, it could be anything. It could be taking time off, doing something to better yourself, working on a project, maybe like I just took a meditation course. I mean, I signed up for a meditation course. That's my focus for January, for the rest of December and January. So that's the kind of stuff that you put there. And then when you look back at the end of the year, you can see, did I do it? How, you know, keep this posted, and it keeps you sort of on track on the themes or the bigger picture of the month.
Right. Exactly. We are not big resolution people here at WBNL Coaching. So this personal section here can really be the things that you can track throughout the year to that, you know, that helps your wellness over the long term. So absolutely right.
Right. So it's a PDF. You can go back in and do it. Now, the next two things that are in here, I really like. And one of them, I got the idea is something Tom Ferry, I think maybe other people have done it too, but this is just your 30, 60, 90 days out. This is a business pipeline thing. So this is meant to just simply be, I've seen people do this with sticky notes, but it's basically who are prospecting. I love this. You could print this out and post this and just simply go, what business do you have coming in the next 30 days? Like people that you're working with, the next 60 days and the next 90 days. And if you use sticky notes with this, you can move them around if things change, or if it's editable, you know, you can change it. And then the next one is the do, doing, done project pipeline. So there's one for business. And I love this do, doing, done in the same idea that these are basically things of here's your major project. So again, in your business, in your home, in your personal life, these are projects that you need to do, and then you move them from the do to the doing. So you always have stuff that's on the do side, then you move them to the doing side. That's what you're working on currently, and then you move them to the done side, the done column. Okay, so that's a cool thing too. And then the rest of the workbook is simply a quarterly tracking sheet. So Matt has put in quarter 1, 2, 3, 4, and inside of each quarter, there is a daily. Is that the first one, daily or weekly?
Daily.
Daily. Okay. I really designed this for me, and I am going to print these out this year and use this as my diary. Okay.
Yeah.
So the daily roadmap, if you're listening, has got 8 blocks on it, and it starts with your morning ritual and a reflections or journaling area. So You write in here your morning ritual. Did you do it? You know, like whatever your 2-3 things that you do, if you're doing the Hal Elrod Savers, or you're just doing meditation and a walk or whatever, you write down, you know what? You probably want to put a date on this. We should have put a date on this.
Well, it's quarter one.
But it's a daily thing. So if somebody was going to print this out, it doesn't matter. They can just, if they're going to do this daily to keep track of it and have 30 days of these documents to hold on to, you would just need to, you know, mark the date that you did it. So daily ritual, and then any journaling that you did that day. What's your focus for day? What's your daily three? Any must have. So there's a place for connections and priorities. So connections are calls, emails, meetings, and so forth. And then priorities are tasks. Now, what goes there? I don't know about you, but I always have at least 20 things on 2 or 3 pads of paper for the different areas of my life.
Yeah.
But what I try to do, and this is where this came from, is pull 3 things I'm going to accomplish today. So who are 3 connections, emails, calls that has to happen today, at least 3 to 5. And then the tasks that you're going to do. You have a task list of a million other things. So why don't you just take 2 or 3 of them and put them on today?
Yeah. Get her done.
And then it ends with evening reflection and a gratitude area. Today I'm grateful for. So it's a full circle daily map. And the weekly roadmap has the similar idea. You can take a weekly roadmap and say, this week I'm going to get Project X done. And then what are my connections and priorities? And then an area for notes. And then you use the daily ones to make it happen. And then the last page that's in the quarterly thing is a tune-up, which is just brilliant. It's the, here's another alliteration. This is
no kidding.
Ponder, practice, perfect, and prosper. You know what? I think that might be the name of the thing that I was talking about, the alliterations with the R, but I believe we're going to use ponder, practice, perfect, and prosper.
We seem to like our P alliterations.
This is nothing more than a quarterly check-in, you know, tune-up. What worked? How did you, once again, back to your sales, your revenue, your expenses. Are you on track? Is everything on track? Did you have any roadblocks, any course corrections you have to make? So it's very simple. It's not overwhelming. And honestly, that's it, right? So we'll kind of demonstrate that a little bit more in our Facebook group and show you, basically demonstrate it, I guess, and fill it all out. And So you, where can you get that? You can go on over to our show notes for episode 145, correct?
That's correct.
And then we created a Google Drive box, basically a vault, as Matt likes to call it, and it will be sitting, any documents that we ever have and share are going to be conveniently located in the vault in the Google Drive. And then after Monday, you'll be able to see a video of kind of walking through this real quick and demonstrating how to use it. And then you can also download them from our Facebook group after Monday. Okay.
Yeah, it's a great tool. It really is. And it's always fun for me every year to put that together, except for the 180 certain text
box. Well appreciated. We thank you.
Good stuff, John O'Brien.